Hello traders, I continue on the next day and the reactor is almost ready, but before I show you the results, I would like to show you four different ways that you can use to test expert advisors for Forex trading. And I showed the three of them in my courses, but in this video I will show you the fourth one, which I used recently, and it works really good for me. And it doesn't really matter which method you will be using, the results will be very similar and you will choose nearly the same expert advisors every time when you're testing. So for the beginners, what's the idea? With EA Studio, we create many expert advisors and we test them to see which are the expert advisors that make most profit on the current market conditions. So the first method I will show you is called out of sample, and this is available in EA Studio. If you click on the generator settings, there is out of sample. So the out of sample is really great method because it allows us to test the expert advisors while we are generating them. For example, if I want to generate strategies for euro dollar, on H1 chart I have my strategy properties of 0.1 lot, minimum 10 pips and maximum 100 pips for the stop loss and take profit range. And then in generator settings we have working minutes, how long we want the generator or the reactor to be working, and then we have the search best, where we can select how we want the software to arrange the strategies into the collection. Usually I keep it to net balance, so on the top I will see the strategies with most profit. And then we have the out of sample. So if I click on it, you will see that I have five different options: 10%, 20%, 30%, 40 and 50, and the sixth option is the in sample. So what is that? Let me generate some strategies very quickly, selecting 20% out of sample. I will remove the acceptance criteria. I will remove Monte Carlo validation as well. And I will click on start. I want to see some strategies very quickly into the collection. Here they are. I will stop the generator. What you notice is that there is this green period for each strategy. And this is what we call out of sample. So all the historical data that we have, in our case, this is from 15th of July 2015 until 15th of July 2020, 5 years of historical data, which means that the complete period is 5 years. And I have selected 20% out of sample, which means that the generator uses 80% of this 5 years of this historical data, and in the recent 20% it backtests the strategy, or in other words, it simulates trading. This is really nice because it's a real simulation. Let me click on the strategy and there is the out of sample monitor, which will show us exactly the dates. So in sample we have the beginning of the historical data, July 2015 until July 2019, and then out of sample is July 2019 and July 2020. Okay, this is very easy because we have exactly 5 years of historical data. 20% out of it is 1 year. Or in other words, it means that the generator has used the first 4 years from the historical data to generate the strategy, and then it simulated trading during the last 1 year. And you can see it's a profitable strategy during the last 1 year. And below we have more details about the in-sample part and about out-of-sample part, and then we have the complete backtest. Okay, so this is the first method that you can use to test the strategies and you are simulating trading back in time, and it works really nice, by the way. And you can change the period or the out of sample to 10% or a higher number. Okay, this is the first method that you can use and that I use when I create strategies using the auto sample in EA Studio. Now, the second method is quite interesting because if you have noticed the in sample, it has 10%, 20, 30, 40, 50. And if I go back to the strategy and I go to 10% out of sample, that would be about 6 months, right? I will be testing the strategy for 6 months. Now, what if you want to test the strategy for just 1 month? This is possible with the data horizon. So we have the start date at 15th of July 2015, and I can set use and date limit just a month ago. All right, so I can put it at 15th of June 2020. What that means is that the generator will use the data except the last 1 month. And if I go back to the reactor, I will remove these strategies that I have generated previously. And you can see 15th of July 2015 until 12th of June 2020. Probably 13th and the 14th of June are the weekend. This is why I have said the 15th, but it starts from 12th. Not probably, but I'm pretty sure this is the reason. So I have removed from the historical data the recent 1 month. Now let me again generate strategies quickly so I can show you what exactly I'm doing. And I already have some strategies into the collection, and I will wait to see at least 15 to 20 strategies. Works a little bit slower now because I have the other three reactors working simultaneously. Okay, 20 strategies. I will stop now. And now what I will do, I will go to data horizon. And one more time, I have removed the recent 1 month from the historical data. And now what I will do, I will change the data horizon to the recent 1 month. So it will be 15th of June 2020 until today, which is already 16th of July 2020. And this means that I have only the recent 1 month now as data horizon. And I will go back to the collection and I will click on Recalculate. This way I will see how these 20 strategies performed during this last 1 month. I have some correlations to be resolved, and here it is. And don't really look at the results because I have run the generator just for less than a minute. But for example, if you look at the first two strategies, what I have here is this strategy had two trades for this month and they were on profit. If I click on report and I go to journal, here they are. I have two short trades, both had $61.80 as a profit. What about the second strategy? It had nine trades during the month. And then if I go to the report, I can see exactly what were the trades, some decent trades over here. Okay, so this is how you can test expert advisors for Forex trading with EA Studio using the historical data. And it's really quick method to do that. Just remove the recent 1 month and then recalculate the strategies for this 1 month. The third method is the most common one, and this is what I show in most of my courses. So let me go back to data horizon. I will bring it back to the way it was 15th of July 2015. And I will not use end date limit. I go back to the collection. I recalculate the strategies that I generated quickly. And here they are. Now, what is the third method? What is the most common way to test expert advisors is to place them on Metatrader with EA Studio. It's very quick because one click and you download the strategies. So when you have many expert advisors, you can put them on Metatrader and leave them trading for 1 month on a virtual account. And then with the magic numbers, we see which are the top performers following the results in FX Blue, my FX book, what I show in my other courses, right? And this is really a great method to test many expert advisors by placing them on MetaTrader. But as you know, each expert advisor works on a separate chart. So sometimes it's a little bit of a work. For example, if you are trading with 99 robots, like what I demonstrate in some of my courses, we need to have 99 different charts open, and then we need to place 99 experts, and it takes some time. For some people, it's a lot of work. For me, it's not, because I'm used with it and it happens quite quickly. But for this method, you need to leave your MetaTrader opened all the time, right? And something very important: if you are testing expert advisors on a demo account to see which are the top performers to place on a live account, make sure you have two MetaTrader platforms installed on your computer. Don't switch between demo and live account, because if you are in demo, you put many expert advisors, they start trading, and then you switch to a live account in the same platform, you will disable the demo account. And the other way around, if you're in a live account and you switch it to demo, you will disable the live account. So if you have live and demo account, you need to have two different platforms. All right, so this is the third method, the one that I show in most of my courses. But one more time, it takes a little bit more work to place each expert advisor on a separate chart. And if you are testing hundreds of expert advisors, it is a lot of work, and this is what I do, but this is my job, so I don't complain about it. Now, the fourth method, which saves me a lot of time, and this is what I will show you in this course, is to generate the strategies, and then I download just the collection. From there, what I do, I wait 1 month. 1 month, I don't do anything. Just wait, prepare my next strategies, I record courses, I travel a lot recently, basically nothing to do with this collection. And this is exactly what I will do in the next lecture. I will show you the results from the reactor that is running right now for the euro dollar, the pound dollar, and the euro pound. And then I will download the collection and I will do nothing for 1 month. Why? After 1 month, I will add the data for the last month. I will download it from the Forex historical data app, and then I will recalculate the strategies in the collection. So this is a real future testing for the strategies. I don't know what will be the data in the next 1 month, right? Nobody knows that, but I'm generating the strategies now, and I will save them as collection. This is the easiest way to go. And after 1 month, I will add this new data in EA Studio and I will recalculate the strategies. And I will see which strategies performed the best during this 1 month. And those strategies I will be trading. This is really saving time method, and I'm using it more and more recently, and I will demonstrate it to you in the course. All right, so thank you for watching this lecture, and in the next one, I will show you the results from the reactors. And then, as I said, 1 month, I will do nothing. I will just wait for the new data to come, and I will show you the whole process and how exactly I'm trading with the strategies and the expert advisors. Thank you for watching, and if you have enjoyed the video, do not forget to like it and subscribe in order to get the latest content from us. Cheers!